Today, I am going to give a lecture on Hamiltonian dynamics, part one. I wish to deliver a few lectures on Hamiltonian dynamics, particularly the fundamentals of Hamiltonian dynamics. First, we will see the generalized momentum and cyclic coordinate. In the case of Lagrangian mechanics, we deal everything with the generalized coordinate and generalized velocity, that is Q's and Q dot. In the case of Hamiltonian, instead of Q, Q dot, we will use P's and Q's, that is position and momentum. In the place of velocity, here we are using generalized coordinate as position and momentum. To define the generalized momentum, particularly you take a simplest case of one-dimensional motion, that is assume the particle is moving along x direction, then the kinetic energy is half mx dot square. If you take partial differentiate with respect to x dot, then you will get mx dot. Mx dot, that is mass into velocity, which is nothing but the momentum. Let us assume that if the potential does not depends on velocity, generally that is the case. We have seen in Lagrangian mechanics also. So since potential is independent of x dot, I have included the potential here minus v because it will not affect your result. So p can be written as partial derivative of t minus v over t partial t x dot. So you know very well that t minus v, kinetic energy minus potential energy, is nothing but your Lagrangian, that is L. So your P is equal to partial derivative of L with respect to x dot. Similarly, for a system described by set up generalized coordinate Q, Q case and generalized velocity K dots, PK is equal to that is P subscript K is equal to partial derivative of L with respect to Q dot Q K dot. From this, this is using the generalized coordinate system. We have seen PK is equal to delta L over delta Q dot Q K dot. This is called conjugate momentum, that is conjugate coordinate, conjugate to the coordinate QK, or it is called canonical momentum. This one is called canonical momentum. For a conservative system, the Lagrangian equations are given by partial time derivative of delta L over delta Q, QK dot minus delta L over delta QK is equal to zero. You just look carefully the red color bond, the term in the red color bond, and you compare this. This is red color is nothing but PK, so it can be rewritten as time derivative of PK is minus delta L by delta QK is equal to zero. So the time derivative of PK minus delta L over delta QK is equal to zero. In the expression for Lagrangian L of a system, a certain coordinate QK does not appear explicitly. Assume that there is no some coordinate. QK is a generalized coordinate. For some coordinate, let us say the L does not depends on theta, or L does not depends on theta dot, something like that. Certain it does not depends certain coordinate. Then you will have TL partial delta TL over TQK is equal to 0 because there is no QK dependence on L. So that is the time derivative of partial TL over TQK dot minus partial TL over partial TQK, which is equal to 0. We have seen that for cyclic coordinate, certain coordinate system, which we are going to call it as cyclic coordinate, certain coordinate system, the L does not depend on it. So this can be ignored. This will become 0. That means the P dot K is equal to the time derivative of delta L over delta QK dot, which is equal to 0. We have seen this term, that is delta L over delta QK dot, is nothing but PK, and its time derivative naturally PK dot, which is equal to 0. We have seen PK dot is equal to time derivative of delta L over delta QK dot, which is equal to 0. If you take integral on left hand side, you will get PK. In the right hand side, you will get the delta L over delta QK dot. And 0, if you integrate 0, naturally you will get a constant. That is, if you differentiate a constant, you will get 0. So if you integrate, that is well known. If you integrate 0, you will get a constant. This is true. You have to realize that this is true only if delta L over delta QK is equal to 0. That is, if L does not depend on QK explicitly. So this is QK is ignorable or cyclic coordinate. Thus, whenever Lagrangian function does not contain a coordinate QK explicitly, the generalized moment of PK is a constant of motion. The coordinate QK is called cyclic or ignorable because we can ignore, since it does not depend, L does not depend on this QK. In other words, the generalized momentum associated with an ignorable coordinate is a constant of motion for a system. We will see the application of cyclic coordinate in the case of central force field. Let us consider the motion of a particle in a central force field. In polar coordinate, the Lagrangian L can be expressed as L is equal to T minus V, that is, T is equal to half m r dot squared plus r squared theta dot squared. This is the term terms I have mentioned in red color point is velocity squared in terms of r and theta. Minus V of R. V does not depends on the velocity. It depends only on coordinate R. Here, L does not contain coordinate theta. If you see the expression, there is no theta term here. Therefore, theta is a cyclic or ignorable coordinate, and hence the generalized momentum P theta correspond to theta is P theta is equal to delta L over over delta theta dot. So if you differentiate this, if you take the derivative with respect to theta dot, first term there is no theta dot, here you have theta dot, which will become 2 theta dot. Theta dot squared, if you differentiate, you will get 2 theta dot. 2 get cancelled. So you will get m r squared theta dot, which is a constant. So p theta is, that is, momentum is a constant, if you have a cyclic coordinate. Here theta is a cyclic coordinate. So the momentum correspond to theta is a constant because theta is a cyclic coordinate. So we have seen p theta is equal to delta L over delta theta dot, which is equal to m r square theta dot, a constant. Just now we have seen it, where the generalized momentum p theta is angular momentum and is a constant of motion in time. Thus, the angular momentum of the system is conserved in central force problem. Further, the constant of motion is called first integral because delta L over delta T dot is a constant, is a first order differential equation and has obtained by integrating this one. Just now we have seen, if you integrate this, that is first term of the Lagrangian equation, because naturally the second one is zero because of cyclic coordinate system. This time derivative of delta L over delta QK dot is equal to zero. We are integrating this. If you integrate this, you will get delta L over delta theta dot, which is a constant. That's what I have mentioned here. Thank you. This is one of the main application of the cyclic coordinate. We will see some more application about the cyclic coordinate. Thank you very much for watching my video and supporting me. If you have any doubts, kindly put your comment in comment box so that I can improve my lecture in future. Thank you.